Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. I hope you're having an amazing day. If you're new here, my name is Emily and I love handbags. I do unboxings, reviews, comparisons, but I also love travel and fashion as well as luxury. So if you like any or all of those things, definitely consider subscribing because I'd love to have you back. If you're back, welcome. Today's video is a tag video. I was tagged by the lovely Luxury Moderation and this tag was created by Jana on YouTube. I'll link both of those ladies' videos below. Thank you so much for creating and tagging me. Today's tag video is about picking one handbag from the 7 brands, and this handbag is one that I don't own but would love to have. So that's right up my alley. I was like, of course I pick a handbag that I don't own that I would love to have. So this is gonna be a very fun one. I hope you enjoy. All right, so I'm gonna follow the list that Luxury Moderation has done. Her first brand is YSL. Now for YSL, I only have 2 bags from them in my collection, and that is the shopping tote. This is one of my original bags, and you can see it's definitely got a few wrinkles in it. There's actually an organizer right there, so it does keep its shape quite well. This is a workhorse. I've used it so much for work, my laptop, everything, and it's still in amazing condition. The other one that I own is the wallet on chain, which I usually like to bring for events and, you know, traveling. But yeah, if I were to add another one that I don't own, I would say it would have to be the Toy Lulu. I have been wanting this last year for a while. I never made the jump because I was afraid that the leather looked too soft and like bubbly, but I have heard really good reviews on it. So if I were to add one from YSL, that would be the one. The next brand on the list is Gucci. Now I only have 1 Gucci bag, which is sitting right here. I brought some bags out for, you know, eye candy. This one is the Ophidia. This one is actually brought back from an older line, and they made it in a smaller size, which is perfect for me. I really love the quality of it, but I have never felt the need to purchase another Gucci bag. But if I were to, I did look at the Gucci Dionysus for a while. I love the like horseshoe bend on the front, and I don't know, just the whole style looks really good. I never made the jump because it looked like it would be very heavy, but I've also heard very good reviews on it. Again, if you own any of these bags, I would love to hear your opinion if you have an experience with it, because obviously I don't own them, so I have no idea. But yeah, that would be the bag I would pick from Gucci. Okay, so the next brand is Celine. I actually have 2 bags from Celine, and they're both vintage bags. This is one of them, and this is, I actually don't know what it's called, but it's in the macadam line, which is like sort of their coated canvas. And this one has a big similarity to like a Kelly or Hermes Kelly bag. But yeah, I love the vintage look of it, and I've meant to fix it up. There's like edges I want to fix up. I have never gotten the chance to. This one, actually, I reviewed it last year, and I have an organizer in there that I specifically made for this bag. If you're interested in personalized organizers for, you know, not just the bags that they have available, I would definitely consider visiting Zoomoni or contacting Zoomoni. I'll leave the information below because they do customized bag organizers. I also have a discount code for that, so I'll also link that below if you're interested so you could save some money. But if I were to pick a Celine bag that I don't currently have, I would have to go with the box bag. I think it's a very classic bag. I think it looks really nice and like elegant and like low key, right? So I think if I were to add something from that brand, it would definitely be that because it's just so classic. The next one we have is Chanel. I really love my Chanel bags. I love all of them. And I actually had a Chanel bag on my wish list for this year, and I hope to get it. So of course, that's the one that I would want to put as my one bag from Chanel to add to my collection. And that would be the Chanel mini rectangle flap. I have the mini square flap in the Pearl Crush right here. I love this mini size. I also have the medium, large, and small classic flaps, but I think the mini sizes are just so great for grab and go. And I really do want a rectangular size to sort of like complete my collection. So I hope to find one in a great color this year. So yeah, stay tuned because I know there are a ton of these ones coming out in the fall winter time. So I'll try to give you an update as soon as I find more information about it. But there's like pinks and blues and purples, iridescents of all these mini flaps. I'm just so excited. So I really do hope to add one of those to my collection this year. All right, the next brand we have is Hermes. If you have not seen my video earlier this year, I just got my first Hermes bag, and it is the Constance. I am so happy that I got this. I've been using it and it still looks great. It has amazing quality. And I think after getting this one, it's just, I mean, I always wanted an Hermes Kelly. And after seeing the craftsmanship and just, you know, the quality of the constants, it's like, I definitely want to get it. So if I were to add a bag from Hermes, it would have to be the Kelly, and I would probably pick the 28 or even the 25. And yeah, I'd probably pick it in the Cellier style and in a more neutral or pastel color. I hope, you know, this year or next year I would be able to add that to my collection, but I don't know, we'll see. Stay tuned to this space if you want to know my next Hermes handbag. We have the brand Louis Vuitton. I have been collecting Louis Vuitton for quite a while now, and I don't know, I feel like I do have a lot of the style bags I'm interested in, but there are a couple more that I have not yet put into my collection, and that is the Capucines and the Petit Mal. Both of these were on my wish list. So yeah, I guess, I don't know, I guess it's hard to pick one of those. If I could only pick one, I'd probably end up putting the Petit Mal as an addition to my collection, just because it's very, very classic. The trunk look, I love it. I've been gravitating towards the trunk look more, but the Capucines, it's like, it's always really pretty. I think why I've never made the jump to the Capucines is because of how similar it looks like the Fendi Peekaboo here. So, I mean, I know there are obviously key differences, but because I have one similar to it already, it's never made me jump to get it. But yeah, I would definitely love that one. But if I could pick only one more to add to my collection from Louis Vuitton, I'd probably have to be the Petit Mal, just because I don't have a trunk look bag. And so yeah, that would be the one. Oh, there's one more, and it's Dior. How did I forget that? So Dior, what would I get from Dior? I have a few things I really love from Dior. I love my Lady Dior's. I also love my Diorama. I love my Dior book tote. Like, they're all very different. And I think if I were to add another bag from Dior, I probably will add the, this one is a little bit tougher because I have not gravitated towards any Dior bags lately. I know they had the Bobby bag. I wasn't super ecstatic about that. It's a great bag, but it wasn't anything that I'm like, I need to have. So I think if I were to add one, I'd probably add the 30 Montaigne. I have wanted the 30 Montaigne, I think, last year. I've since then decided that I don't need it because I have similar style bags, or that it looked very similar to my Diorama in terms of like shape. But I don't know, if I were to add one, I think that would be the one that I that would pick. I love the silhouette. I love the locking mechanism. And I just love that you can also wear it three ways: crossbody, on the shoulder, short or long. So yeah, I probably end up getting that one from Dior. And so those are the seven brands that is in this tag. I hope you enjoyed. Again, if you have any of these bags, let me know how you what you think of it. I'm not saying I'm going to add every one of these to my collection right now, but it'd be good to know if that is something I should consider in the future. Oh, I just wanted to point out, I know a lot of you have asked me about this, but Senreve has their revival sale still, and they've just restocked. I was able to actually get one of the colors I was looking for in the Aluna during the sale. And don't forget, you can get an additional $50 off of the sale price with the code ANGELEYN50 if you're interested. I just thought I'd put that out there because so many of you have asked me throughout the year, and this only happens twice a year. So definitely consider looking at it, getting it while the sale is still going on. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you guys in my next one. Bye.